Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show how you can generate random data rather very quickly online. So why do you need random data? Let's suppose you are working on the database side of stuff and you're creating some ETL packages or you're creating reports or you have a set of tables that you've just created but no data to test the structure with, right? So that is where random data really helps. If you cannot wait for production data to make its way to the database, you can generate random data on your own, load it to the database, and do all sorts of testing on it, right? So we are going to go through two websites that I use, and you'll see how quickly you can generate random data that should suit most of your requirements. So the first website that we are looking at is mockaroo.com. I have included the link for this in the video description. Okay, so once you land at this page, you'll notice that a set of columns are already available here. You may choose to keep them, or if you want to rename them, you can go ahead. So let me first show you how you can remove a column. So you just click on the cross button and you can remove a column. Once you're done, if you want to add another field, just click on add another field and make sure you give it a distinct header name. In this case, I'll give address. Now, once you have defined the set of columns that you would want in your random data, the next most important step is to select the type. So the type is similar to data type, but it's not just a data type, it's a data collection. All right, so let me demonstrate that with an example. Now, let me close it and I'll select the address. So address, as you can see, by default, it has taken the type from the previous column, which is email address. We would certainly want to change that because I'm looking for a geographic address. So let me scroll down. Or I can search here. Okay, so there is a street address. I'm going to select this. And for the rest of them, I just want to check if it's fine. It's row number, first name, last name, email address, and street address. So, all right. So let me click on download data. Okay, so downloads as an Excel file, or I believe it's a CSV file. All right, so this is a CSV file, right? So as you can see, this is random data, right? It looks so real though, right? So you have the ID, first name, last name, email, and the address. This is not confidential data. This is not data that belongs to organization. This is purely random data, which means you can take it, you can store it in any database that you want, and you can, you know, do some checks on it, right? Without the fear of having taken data that belongs to someone. Nobody owns this data. This is completely randomly generated data. All right. So let me show you some other options. The format, you can choose to keep it CSV, or there are other options as well, such as JSON, tab delimited, SQL, Excel, XML, and so on. And then you can choose to keep the header. You can also choose how much percentage of the column will be null, or how much a percentage of the records will be blank, right? So you can choose to keep your data completely dense or sparse. And by default, it generates only up to 1,000 records. If you want more, you would have to sign up to their service. So this is about mockaroo.com. Let me show you the second website, which is generatedata.com. So generatedata.com, a lot similar to Mockaroo. There are some UI differences. So let me type a name here. So I'll select sample dataset. You'll have to type in the column names. And once you're done, you'll have to select the data type. This is very similar to Mockaroo. This is not just a type, this is a collection. So I'll select the first name, last name, and email address. You see, once you select first name, there are some more options available, such as you want a gender specific name, or any gender's name is fine. You can select all these options. And by default, this generates only 100 records. So that's quite less in comparison to Mockru, but still, you may find it useful. So it takes a little longer to execute, but it does. So you'll see that the data output is in HTML. So let's go and change that. I'll change it to a CSV with a delimiter character with comma. All right. Now you can choose to copy paste this into a notepad, or you can even click on prompt to download, and it will prompt you to save a file, just like what happened with mockru.com, right? So I use Mockru mostly. Generate data, not so much. As you can see, the generate data website, although it's simple, it's not as user friendly or as rich as the Mockru, right? So still, if you use both of them together, it's very useful, because then you get a lot of random data that does not overlap, right? The chances of the data overlapping is quite less, right? So you may want to have this as a bookmark and refer to it as required. I hope you find this useful. Thank you.